1979, when he purchased the vineyard La Grola, he introduced a new method in Valpolicella. In fact, I don't know if you have been to Valpolicella, but in Valpolicella the vines are planted in a very unusual way with the pergola. Pergola. Pergola means that you have the vine, which is quite high, and then you have the canopy on top, which is more or less 2 meters high. But with pergola you don't plant densely because you need the vines to develop the canopy. So my father, he paid only one visit to California and he said, why they plant so densely? And then he said, maybe we can try with the Corvina, with our grape variety. And so in 1979, when he was planting La Grola, he introduced the double Guyot system in Valpolicella. And he understood a very important concept that it's not the quantity that you produce per vine, per hectare, that is an important factor, but it's the quantity that you produce per vine. And so by planting the double Guyot, he doubled the number of vines per hectare, but with the view of each single vine to produce less quantity, but grapes with more concentration. And this was a kind of revolution for the Valpolicella. And at the beginning he was criticized, but now if you go around in Valpolicella, you can see that 50% of the vineyards are planted exactly as he did in 1979. And I will explain this concept more when we taste Palazzo della Torre and La Grola, what this means in terms of the resulting wine.